isn't my house.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the fuck?
Not nice! There's a giant hand!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Leafs lose 6-2 to the Ottawa Senators, and that's really inconvenient because we were doing a live event tonight, and we were all kind of vibing and having a good vibing time, and then they friggin'... What was that?
First, think you know which way it's going to go? Gear bet at Sports Interaction. When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered before the game, live betting on all major sports and prop bets. Do they have one on overtime ending in 15 seconds? Want to bet? Visit sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the brand new app. It's 19 plus though. Please play responsibly.
Now, believe it or not, this is one of those games where I'm willing to give them a I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed. It doesn't need to always be yelly and screamy, and it's not just because I have strep throat. I have strep throat. I wish I didn't have strep throat, but I got... What are you laughing at? Lauren Williamson of Game Over? Stop it!
Robert Malloy.
I saw that. It's fine. And the band's playing. Do you hear the band? Gosh! I can't be mad. These are the, you can't, imagine getting upset and getting into an argument with these lights around you. How stupid would you feel? There's a band.
What?
Adam said explain the band.
Well, here. Well, there's a band playing downstairs.
Well, that's
yeah.
That's explain it. They're on an NHL.
Oh, you kidding me. Have fun with this one, Drew.
There's a band. And they're on NHL, and they're called Orson Welles, and you should.
Orson Wilde.
Suck at this.
They're part of my family. The microphone's here, so.
So we're up here in the nerd room, and then there's a band playing downstairs, and then the next floor down is where we had the event, and then in the basement there's some like football team down there. We're at the mansion in Kingston, Ontario. You see, I probably should have led with that. This is the building that we were supposed to have a live event on, or in April 4th, 2020. But then, I don't know if you recall, you might recall, there was a global thing. And so we couldn't do that anymore. And we vowed that our first live event after all of that garbage would be here. And here we are, nearly three stinking years later. And the Leafs, obviously, didn't care about that because they got their bottoms kicked. Now it was close for a while. And yes, the Sens scored early, but then Joey Anderson, that's not just a goal, it's a vibey goal. You feel good for Joey Anderson. He doesn't score a lot. Was that his first as a Leaf? I'm not actually sure, but you would have believed me if I told you so. It's his second. Lauren says it's his second. That's only one after his first. That's his sophomore goal. That's like when you get a card and it's got 1 year's worth of stats on it, and you go, this is a rookie card. And your friend who knows things about cards is like, yeah, sure it is. It's not, when you see a card like that, it's not a rookie card, and I just never have the strength to tell people. It makes them happier. And obviously it was 2-2, Willie with the goal there, and there's a little bit of controversy with Willie because it looked like he was the guy who took Matt Murray out of this game, and I suppose that's the story about the game. Let's get into that for a sec. Elliot Friedman said, post-game, Toronto coach Sheldon Keefe, I like that he specified that, like we don't know. Thank you. Thanks, Fried. Told reporters Matt Murray had something that flared up, making the goalie unavailable. Keith added it is not related to Murray's adductor injury from earlier this season. Mike Stevens had a few follow-up points that, to me, were particularly juicy. By juicy, I mean concerning. Keith says if Samsonov was forced to leave the game, they would have gone to an e-bug despite Murray being on the bench. Can I spend a moment on that? Why? Like, okay, I'm not, I suppose I believe that. I have no reason not to believe that. If Murray is not good to go, if you have any professional athlete who is not good to go, what's he doing on the bench? Like, if it's a championship game and you got Marie-Philippe Poulin there and she's there for vibes, because why wouldn't you have her there for vibes? I suppose I understand that. This is a regular season game in January. Why is Matt Murray. He should be off with the training staff or whatever. Not knowing what the injury was, I couldn't tell. I'm not going to go down to the bench myself and give him a massage. Hey, Matt, I'm Steve. Although we met once before, I suppose it wouldn't be that weird. Do you think we'd be friends? No, because I'm not invited to the mustache club where it's for people who can grow mustaches. His is good and regal. Mine is depressing, and for Movember, can I please just donate? Can I just... Keith also said that it puts Samsonov in a terrible spot, which, yeah, it very obviously did. And then also, when asked about Pontus Holmberg in his top six debut, he said 6 penalty minutes is too much. So rather than go through this goal by goal, I think we can pretty safely look at the 4 unanswered goals at the end and simply say the Leafs got their butts kicked. This was their first game without Matthews, and they're going to be without him for 3 weeks. And their starting goaltender, who wasn't very good, came in at the last minute. And I think we can throw Samsonov a little bit of a bone here. That was his first regulation loss on home ice. It is almost February. Strep throat. What I want to see from the Leafs out of the next 2 games is extremely important, because I made a video earlier today about what the next little bit is going to be like without Austin Matthews. Go and check that out. It's also here on the YouTube channel. Click like and subscribe and all those things. They have 2 games left before the All-Star break. 3 games, right? You get the Sens, and then you have 2 teams who are at very least in the playoffs. You get the Washington Capitals, and then you have the Boston Bruins, who are the playoffs. There was probably an element of the Leafs that was like, you know what? No Matthews, let's just survive. Let's just try to survive until the break. And they didn't even do that. The next 2 games need to not be about surviving. They need to be about thriving. They need to be about not abandoning your goaltender, as they did several times tonight. They need to be about identifying when it is and isn't okay to try to be TJ Brody, despite not being TJ Brody. Connor, how do we feel after Drew did that to us, Connor? And the worst part of all, this is the worst part. I have to put Timothy Liljegren in, dang it. You scored on your own net, Tim. I saw you score the game tying goal the other day, and we were all very happy. We said, hooray, Tim. That way we didn't even say yes. We said, hooray, Tim. And then you score on your own net. Now what am I supposed to do, Tim? Why don't you strap on goalie pads and drive into the corner? Why don't you? Breaking my heart, Tim. So, the next 2 games need to be focus. Because, listen, the Leafs should feel good about themselves. I know I criticize them. You gotta expect more from your team if you want them to win the Stanley Cup. I don't think that's weird. But the Leafs deserve, because of the season they've had so far, to feel good about themselves. Put in a good performance against Washington. You don't even have to win. I'd really like you to. But just put in a better performance than that, for goodness sake, against Washington. And I tell you what, nothing will make you feel better about yourself than beating the Bruins heading into the All-Star break. Let's get it done, boys. Because once you come out of the All-Star break, no, you won't have Matthews. And you might not even have Murray. We don't even know what's going on there, because the Marlies are on a weird little road trip right now, a long one, because several different organizations take over their building for weeks at a time every year. But you have Shelgren, who is giving you good minutes, and you have Wohl, who looks like he's got a lot of good minutes in him. And once you come out of the break, it's a back-to-back home-and-home against Columbus. They stink. You get Chicago. They stink. Montreal. They stink. And are undefeated against you. Unforgivable. And then you get Chicago again. They stink twice. Worth mentioning, by the way, against the worst teams in the NHL, the Leafs have a 4-4-3 record against them. That's 500 to Gary Bettman, but that's 3 more losses than wins in my books. Please stop! But it also means we can expect more out of them over the next 2 games. These guys are all taking a selfie in the background. Can you send that to me so we can put it in the video? Questions? First, from Charlie Arsenault. It's a good thing I couldn't make it to Kingston tonight. Otherwise, I would have been fired by the end of the game. Hope you guys had a great time. We didn't, Charlie. You're fired. That's for legal purposes. That's a joke. We like Charlie. It's one of the hosts of Game Over Ottawa, along with Maud. From El Celdo, Frog is here. Don't be sad. Things will be okay. Thank you, Frog. That was kind. Holmberg, how do we feel about him in an elevated role? Uh-oh. I tell you what, based on him this season and that ridiculous goal he scored against Shesterkin, I thought he was ready for this. He proved in this game that he's not. But I tell you what, hockey changes pretty fast. I don't think Sheldon Keefe is going to be like, all right, emergency break, Kerfoot up to the second line right away. Again, these next two games are big. Against Washington, I think you got a good chance to prove yourself. Against the Bruins, you have a good chance of getting eaten alive. These next two games, no matter how good the beginning of his career he's had, are going to be the next, they're going to be the biggest games of Holmberg's life so far. Above any championship he won in Sweden, yes. Also, three penalties in a single game. My bet is that's the last time he does that in his career. And that's on the Dangle Jinx. I'm throwing down the gauntlet. And this is the last one, and I think it's very important. A lot of you need to hear this. This was the first game I attended in over 3 years. Can you make me feel better? No. No. No, what do you want me to do? Have them unlose? To talk about how this loss is good? No. You do what I did as a wee child, and you let it sting and fester in you forever. And then you get over it because they win the next time, and you forget why you were ever mad. And then they lose again, and you remember exactly why you were mad. And then they win again, and you forget it all over again. That is your life. That is your, what you are as a sports fan, specifically as a Leafs fan. And when they finally win the thing, instead of throwing up your hat like you're at graduation and freaking out all over the place, we're all just going to drop to our knees and all on each other's shoulders and just cry. We're just going to openly weep for 3 hours. Just relief. Then you celebrate. What was the last game you went to? I'm just curious. Anyway, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Did you hear the band? Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. What should they tell them? Shut up!
'Cause like I know it's an accident, but that's also the second time he's done that to a goalie. He did it to Garrett Sparks,
yeah.
Which in hindsight, fair. But like we didn't know that at the time. You know, you're not supposed to. I am not a hockey player, and I know there are several rules that you're supposed to follow, and one is don't shoot high on the freaking goalie during warm-ups. And this is the second time he's done it, but supposedly it's a mess in the post-game because Samsonov
misheard a question.
Misunderstood a question. Willie refutes that it was his fault. Like, apparently Sheldon Keefe is about to talk about it, and we haven't even seen it.
Oh, shit, really?
Like, it hasn't even happened yet.
Oh, we're getting the juicy details as it's going on.
It's friggin' chaos right now. Can we use this clip in the LMR?
I'm going to make that the screen cap.